Presidente, no último dia 20, 11 dias antes do início da COP26, um grupo de países em desenvolvimento publicou um manifesto assinado em La Paz, na Bolívia, dizendo que a proposta de net zero em 2050, né, de zerar as emissões em 2050, que vem sendo defendida principalmente pelos países desenvolvidos, puxados pelos Estados Unidos, ia contra o conceito de justiça climática. Esses países argumentam que os países desenvolvidos, primeiro, adiaram a ação climática e agora que eles já desenvolveram a tecnologia de energias renováveis para vender no mundo inteiro, eles pressionam para que todo mundo acelere, todos os países, inclusive os países em desenvolvimento, acelerem o corte de emissões. E esses países, que são os chamados like-minded developing countries, né, que são os países, a linha dura dos países em desenvolvimento nas negociações, argumentam que eles não deveriam ser obrigados a fazer isso. Existe alguma justiça nessa reclamação por parte desses países?
It is a very interesting question, and it's one that I felt it important in my foundation on climate justice that we would study really thoroughly whether that argument was valid. And it isn't valid for a reason that's very clear when you look into it. As I mentioned, the first injustice is that climate change affects much earlier and much disproportionately heavier the poorest countries, the poorest communities, the small island states and indigenous peoples. So if countries say, we weren't responsible for the earlier emissions, we're going to now develop our oil and coal and gas and just go ahead, they will be the most affected first, that country's people. That's just it's a location unfairness as well. They're the parts of the world that are already most vulnerable, and therefore they would be affected earliest and worst. So it's not an argument, let me put it this way, it's an argument of science that is objective across the board, that we absolutely have to align with 1.5 degrees. I think we should do it before 2050 myself. But I'm glad that countries and companies are making that commitment. We tried at Paris to get more attention to that, and we got a little bit. But now there is much more attention by governments. Something it's become a standard of nationally determined contributions to build in to be net zero. I think the young people are exasperated and say 2050 is far too long away. What are you going to do this year, next year, the year after, up to 2030? And I absolutely agree that that needs to be the focus, of course. But the long-term goal, as it's called, puts a kind of discipline into how the voluntary commitments, because after all, they are voluntary because of Paris, how they will be done. And it's peer pressure, then pressure of countries, pressure on companies, working, in a way that forces, and money is changing, investment is moving quite quickly to only investing in renewables. And I do believe that developing countries may need, for example, I'm conscious of the need for gas in Africa as a just transition to being able to have renewable energy. You need a baseload of electricity that helps you then to turn green in the way that developing countries have done, but it should be a just transition and be well over by 2050.